Alright, today we want to talk a little bit about functions and how we use them in mathematics. So before we do that, I want to talk first about relations. And a relation is any correspondence between two sets or groups of items. So an example of that might be somebody's name and their phone number. So my name is Joanna, and over here in this other set you have my phone number, whatever it is. And then you can also have my office number. Like this. And then you might have somebody else's name, my friend Vince, and you have his cell number. Okay? That's a relation. It's just any sort of connection between two sets. Okay? So then after we talk about relations, we want to move on. Oh, before I move on, I want to say that we have, for these different sets, this is what I would call the input parameter, and this is what I usually refer to as the output of the function or the relation. And in mathematics, a list of all the inputs is called the domain, and the outputs is called the range. Okay? So we have that kind of setup for a relation, any sort of correspondence between two sets. When we move down to functions, a function is a relation, a correspondence between two sets, that assigns each input to exactly one output. So our example above was not a function because you saw my name, Joanna, being assigned to two different outputs, my cell number and my work number. So that is set up right there where my input is going to my cell and work means that this is not a function. Now, the nice things about function is that they are predictable. And this is why we work with them a lot. Whenever I know what the input is, immediately the function should do the same thing over and over again and give me the same output. So each time I put in the input, I get the same output. An example from real life of a function is my name or people's names and their height. Each person has exactly one height associated with them. So when I put Joanna in as the input parameter, the output, if we had a list of everyone's height, would be my actual height. Okay? And then likewise, my friend Vince might be in here. And his height, 6 feet, 9 inches, 6 feet tall. Okay? So something like that. So we like them. They're very predictable. Okay? There are multiple ways to talk about functions, different function forms, so I want to go ahead. And some of them are like I have been showing you, so I'll show you them kind of side by side for things. And let me go ahead. So this is I want to look here. This is a function. And the function form can look like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 7, 12, 3 minus 1 in the output. And then let's say 1 is being mapped to 7, 2 to 12, 3 is also being mapped to 7, and 4 is being mapped to negative 1. This is, in fact, a function. I can see 1 is going to 7 and 3 is going to 7. That's fine, as long as when I put 1 in, I know exactly where it's going, and when I put 3 in, I know exactly where it's going. So not a function over here in this mapping might look like this, the same. Oops, let me change colors. Don't want to write in red. So, but something that is not a function might look like this, where 1 is being mapped to both 7 and 3, 2 is going to 12, maybe 4 is going to 3 and also to negative 1, and maybe 3 is going to 12. And the main problem here is this behavior right here, where you see one input branching off and going to two different outputs. Okay, these two are examples, or this one over here is an example of a function map. Another way to write this is as a list of ordered pairs, inputs and outputs. So it's the input, comma, the output. Just like we would see x, comma, y. So this one that I just gave you would look something like this. 1, comma, 7 in an ordered pair. 2 going to 12. 3 also has output 7. And 4 has output negative 1. Okay? So when I do that, this is another example of a way to list the function or to describe the function is as a list of ordered pairs. You can see it there. Okay? Now, you can list relations as ordered pairs as well. Over here, I could list this one. 1, 7, 1, 12, 2, 12. 3 is going to 12, 4 to 3, and 4 to negative 1. And you can identify this behavior that's problematic here because, again, I have the same input parameter, 1 and 1 in two different ordered pairs, and it's going to two different output parameters there. Okay, and so I also want to say this leads us, or this idea of describing functions as ordered pairs, inputs and outputs, will lead eventually to the vertical line test, which we'll do when we talk about graphing. Okay, so the last thing that I want to talk about is about notation for functions. So there is a third way to write functions. And it's really a shorthand, and you are probably familiar with it. It looks something like this. F, open parentheses, x, close parentheses, equals x plus 3. Okay? So this is read out loud, or you'll hear me say f of x. In this case, x is the input parameter. And we also call x the independent variable. When we graph things, we usually graph y is equal to f of x, the output of the function. So always when we're talking about the variable x, that's my input parameter, f of x is an output. So this is often called the dependent variable, and it is most definitely the output of this function. Okay? So let's do a couple examples evaluating functions. So for f of x is equal to 3x plus 2, find. And we'll do part A, F of 5. So F of 5, you see 5 in the place of x here. They're holding the same spot inside this function. And that means everywhere I see x in the original, I want to plug in F of 5. So here I'll write the original again. F of x is equal to 3x plus 2. And when I go to F of 5 and plug in the 5, I plug it there, and I plug it in here. Now, a quick tip, you'll see that I plugged it in parentheses. That's always good to do when you're plugging things in, especially until you get used to this notation, to make sure you don't miss anything. So 3 times 5 is 15 plus 2, that should be 17. So B, I want to find F of negative x. Same exact thing. I want to start with my original function, 3x plus 2. And now in this line, everywhere I see x, I'm going to plug in negative x in parentheses. So I get negative 3x plus 2. Simplify. So F of negative x is equal to negative 3x plus 2. Let's do one more. F of x plus h. So I'm going to start again. F of x, oops, I want to get rid of that. F of x, start with the original, and plug in x plus h everywhere. I get 3x plus 3h plus 2.